In Armored Core 6, you can replay missions and do it in the most efficient and fastest way possible and earn ranks. But before we dive into the how, we should think of the why first. Why do you want to get an S rank? Or why do you want to replay missions to get an S rank? There are no meaningful rewards in doing this. The only thing that you get is an emblem and achievement. Both doesn't contribute to you in terms of gameplay. For me, my reason is that I used to watch Gundam and mecha animes. I want to replicate where the character goes into a mission, destroy everything, and leave like a boss, like it's the easiest job in the world. They go into the mission and then they go out flawlessly, and that is what I want to replicate. Armored Core 6 is one of the smoothest movement action game I've played. Not only that, you are given a lot of choices from AC, weapons, melee weapons, boosters, and shoulder weapons. These tools are provided so you can finish the job the way you want. Last but not the least is that I enjoy the game so much to the point that I'm willing to S rank every mission and to see what it feels like using the best build that you can create in a mission. My reason may not be grand, but you have to have a reason. So I ask you, are you planning on replaying all the missions and get S rank? What is your reason for replaying all missions and achieving S rank? Now that you have a reason for why you want to S rank missions, let's talk about the how. First, you have to be fast. Fast means you finish the mission at a decent amount of time. You can use any AC that you are comfortable with, but it's preferable that you use a fast AC to traverse terrain and get to your objective. You can actually use heavy AC, you just have to be mindful of your pathing. You have to remember to go to a path that will lead you to the fastest route. A good example of this is the mission Coral Expert Denial. This mission requires you to be fast and at the same time be able to fly at a certain height. So my advice is to avoid heavy AC. I mean, you can use heavy AC, but it will be difficult. I'm not saying that it's impossible, it's just that it will be a very difficult task. Ammo consumption is calculated at the end of the mission. If you use too much ammo, this might be the reason why you can't get an S rank on a mission. But the game is actually very forgiving because there are missions where it doesn't care too much about ammo consumption as long as you beat the mission or the boss very fast. So chain guns or gatling guns are still viable, but not all missions. Also, if you are doing a mission that gets you to fight a boss right away, the game is actually very forgiving when it comes to ammo consumption. My advice is to test it and see what happens. So this is one of the toughest part in S ranking a mission, not taking too much damage. To S rank a mission, you need to take the least amount of damage. You need to end the mission with 2 repair kits. You are also given only 1 attempt to do the mission, so that means you can't use a save point. If you make a mistake, you might as well restart the mission and do it all over again. There are save points in every mission, but you can't use save point. It will automatically forfeit S rank. Last but not the least, you need to eliminate the enemy forces and destroy the main objective. This means that you have to do the mission fast and at the same time need to destroy enemy targets and enemy forces. You can't just speedrun and avoid the enemies. You have to destroy them, but not all of them. You can destroy enemy forces around 40%, which is very forgiving. So these are the things that you need to do in order to S rank a mission. If I miss any, please write it down in the comments below. And thank you for watching and have a nice day.